فؤادك الأيام فتى.
تفضل.
فبين الله هذا بيانا شافيا تفهمه العوام.
الشيخ رحمه الله، الشيخ محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله يصير فبين الله، الله تبارك وتعالى he clarified هذا this. What did he clarify? The unity in the religion and the prohibition of differing in the religion. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he clarified it. A clarification which is shafiyan. That is, that cures. تفهمه العوام. The layman will understand it. Awam is a layman. The general mass, the general folks, تفهمه, they will understand it. نعم.
ونهانا أن تكون أن نكون كالذين تفرقوا واختلفوا قبلنا فهلكوا. وذكر أنه أمر المسلمين بالاجتماع في الدين ونهاهم عن التفرق فيه.
عن التفرق فيه.
عن التفرق فيه.
And he prohibited from us أن نكون, for us to be, كالذين تفرقوا, like those who differed, واختلفوا, and disputed, قبلنا, those who came before us, فهلكوا, and they became destroyed. وذكر, and he mentions, أنه أمر المسلمين, that he ordered the believers, بالاجتماع, to unite, في الدين, in the religion, وناهاهم, and he prohibited them from, عن التفرق فيه, to differ within the religion. Now.
ويزيده وضوحا ما وردت به السنة من العجب العجاب في ذلك.
And what increases it in clarity, ويزيده, and what increases it وضوحا, clarity, is ما وردت, that which has been transmitted, that which the sunnah has transmitted, وردت به السنة, or that which is transmitted in the sunnah, من العجب العجاب, from the fascinated, most fascinated thing, في ذلك, in this matter.
ثم صار الأمر إلى أن الافتراء افتراق في أصول الدين وفروعه هو العلم, هو العلم والفقه, فقه في الدين.
And after that, the matter became إلى أن الافتراق, that the disagreement and the differing في أصول الدين, in the fundamental matters of the religion, وفروعه, and its sub-branches, هو العلم, it is the knowledge, والفقه, and it's the comprehension and the understanding في الدين, in the religion.
وصار الاجتماع وصار الاجتماع في الدين لا يقوله إلا زنديق أو مجنون.
وصار الاجتماع, and the unity became في الدين, in the religion, لا يقوله, no one says it, إلا زنديق, a heretic, أو مجنون, one that is crazy. الشرح, the explanation of الشيخ محمد بن صالح العثيمين. قوله, the statement of the Shaykh. So now we're going to take the wording of Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen. قوله, the statement of Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, where he said, أمر الله بالاجتماع, Allah ordered us to come with unity, في الدين, in the religion, ونهى عن التفرق فيه, and he prohibited us to differ, إلى آخره, to the ending of that paragraph. إلخ means what? It means إلى آخره, to the ending. Ibn Uthaymeen says, Al-Aslu Thani, the second foundation, this one is, من الأصول التي ساقها الشيخ رحمه الله, in which the author brought, may Allah have mercy upon him, which is الاجتماع, unity, في الدين, in the religion, والنهي عن التفرق فيه, and the prohibition in differing in the religion. وهذا الأصل, this foundation, العظيم, this great foundation, قد دل عليه كتاب الله, Allah's kitab indicates it. وَسُنَّةُ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم's traditions also indicates this strong, this great foundation. The Sunnah also shows it. وَعَمَلُ الصَّحَابَةِ And the actions of the Sahabas also indicate this great fundamental matter. وَسَلَفُ الصَّالِحُ رَحِمَهُمُ اللَّهُ And the pious predecessors, their actions also indicate the importance of this qa'ida of this asal. Now the Sheikh is going to bring each one inshaAllah ta'ala. أَمَّا كِتَابُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى As for the book of Allah indicating it. Where is the evidence for that? فَقَدْ قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ Allah said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Those of you who believe, اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ فِيَ اللَّهِ Or have taqwa, have God consciousness. حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ The way he deserves to be feared. So taqwa means what? أَيْتَقُوا اللَّهَ اتِّقَاءً حَقًّا وَاجِبًا بِفِعْلِ مَا أَمَرَ بِهِ وَاجْتِنَامِ مَا نَهَا عَنُهُ By coming with that which he ordered you to come with and staying away from that which he prohibited from you. That's the one that's needed from you. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ And do not die. إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ Do not die except you guys are believers. Die in a state of Islam. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ And do not die. إِلَّا except وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ Whilst in a state of Islam. وَاعْتَصِمُوا Hold on to. بِحَبِلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا Hold on to the rope of Allah. Together. So pay attention. We were ordered to hold on to the rope of Allah, but not every individual by himself. Together. We all hold on to that together. Holding on to the rope of Allah is what? Holding on to the covenant we made with Allah. Holding on to the religion of Allah. Holding on to the book of Allah. Holding on to the and following of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of those are aqwal, statements that were said by the mufassirin. And those statements are all what? Ikhtilafu tanawwu'. The difference is only the wordings. It is not ikhtilafu tadad. And we studied that in our kitab, Muqaddimatu fi usul tafsir, li-Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. Wa'atasimu, hold on to. Bihabilillahi, the rope of Allah, jami'an, together. So we have to realize this point and it's important. Unity is not praiseworthy in and within itself, it is if. But it's only praiseworthy when the unity is upon the haqq. And that's why you see Allah is elaborating on that part. Wa'atasimu, hold on to. Bihabilillahi jami'an, onto the rope of Allah together. وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا And don't differ in the religion. Don't differ. وَذْكُرُوا Remember, نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ Allah's blessing on you. إِذْ كُنْتُمْ When you guys were أَعْدَاءً enemies. فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ And Allah brought your hearts to one another. أَلَّفَ is when the hearts, they come together. Allah brought your hearts together. فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ And you became بِنِعْمَتِهِ Based on the blessing of Allah, you became إِخْوَانًا Brothers. وَكُنْتُمْ And you guys were عَلَى شَفَى حُفْرَةِ مِنَ النَّارِ You were on the brink of the fire. You were on the edge of destruction. What happened? فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا Allah saved you from it. كَذَلِكَ Like that. يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ Like that Allah clarifies for you. آيَاتِهِ His signs, His verses. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ So you can become those who are guided. So you can become those who are guided. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى Allah also says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا Do not become like كَالَّذِينَ تَفَرَّقُوا Like those who differed. وَاخْتَلَفُوا And they disputed. When did they dispute? مِن بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتُ When clear-cut evidence came to them is when they disputed and differed. وَأُولَٰئِكَ And for those people is لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ For them is a punishment. عَظِيمٌ Great punishment. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى Allah also said, وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا Do not dispute one another. فَتَفْشَلُوا And you lose. وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ And your strength goes. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ Those who dispute in their religion. وَكَانُوا شِيَعًا And they become فِرَقًا وَأَحْزَابًا As Imam Abu Abdullah al-Qurtubi said, وَكَانُوا شِيَعًا They become groups and sects. لَسْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ You have nothing to do with them. Allah, شَيْءٍ is نَكِرَةٌ فِي سِيَاقِ النَّفِي You have nothing to do with them, Muhammad. Nothing. فَتَعُمْ It shows generalization. Nothing whatsoever. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى Allah also said, شَرَعَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ Allah has legislated from the religion. مَا وَصَى بِهِ نُوحًا That which Allah تبارك وتعالى has spoken to Nuh alayhi salam regarding. وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ And that which we have sent you, Muhammad, as a revelation as well. So it's something that we said to Nabiullah Nuh before you as a wasiyyah. وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ And that which we have sent on you, Muhammad, as a revelation as well. وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ إِبْرَاهِيمِ And it's also a wasiyyah to Nabiullah Ibrahim as well. وَمُوسَى And Nabiullah Musa. وَعِيسَى And Isa. These are أُولُو الْعَزْمِ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ The five elite chosen prophets. Nabiullah Muhammad, Nuh, Ibrahim, Musa and Isa. Five of the greatest prophets. Look what Allah told all five of them. أَنْ أَقِيمُ الدِّينَ Establish the religion. وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ And do not dispute and differ within the religion. So pay attention. Underline two things of that verse. أَنْ أَقِيمُ الدِّينَ That's the first part. وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ Number two. Establish the religion first. We can only unite on both of us establishing the religion. We can't unite on everyone's logic and intellect. Na'am. So this is a wasiyyah of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to Nuh, to Nabiullah Ibrahim, and then Musa, and then Isa, and then our messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So uniting upon the haq is a us, min usuli ahli sunnah. It is a asal, it's a fundamental matter from the fundamental matters of Ahlul Sunnah. And I want all the time to remember that unity, when we differ upon matters that we differ on aqaid matters, usul, kulli, and we unite just for the fact of unity, that is not the praiseworthy one. And we mentioned that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He spoke against the Jews for that. تَحْسَبُهُمْ جَمِيعًا You think they're together. وَقُلُوبُهُمْ شَتَّى And their hearts are not with one another. So to just to unite for the sake of uniting is not praiseworthy. But to unite upon the haqq is what's praiseworthy. To unite upon the haqq and the truth and everybody coming with the following, the Masdar al-Talaqi is the same. Al-Kitab wa-Sunnah bi-Fahmi Salaf al-Ummah. But to unite with a Rafidhi who is insulting Abi Bakr and Umar and Uthman and the Sahaba to say, I'm going to unite with them. Why are you going to unite with them? The reason why I'm uniting with them is because unity is needed. And then we read these ayat, then that is lack of comprehension of what the ayat are talking about. An aqimu ad-deena wa la tatafarraqu fihi. Fafi hadhihi al-ayati. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen says, in these verses there are فَفِي هَذِهِ الْآيَاتِ نَهَى اللَّهُ Allah prohibited. In these verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He prohibited عَنِ التَّفَرُّقِ To differ and to dispute one another. وَبَيَّنَ And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala clarified عَوَاقِبَهُ The consequences of it. الْوَخِيمَ The evil consequences of it. Wakhima is the evil consequences. Wakhima is something evil. And who is that consequences or that evil consequences? Who is it upon? Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen said, عَلَى الْفَرْدِ It's on individuals. The consequences are bared by individuals. وَالْمُجْتَمَعِ And the community and the society will face the problem. وَالْأُمَّةِ بِأَسْرِهَا And the ummah in its whole. بِأَسْرِهَا means from all of its corners. They will face the suffering, they will face the pain of disunity. And wala shak, wala raib, we face that issue today. We face that issue today, which is the tafarruq and the ikhtilaf that occurred amongst the ummah, what it has caused to the individuals and its communities and societies and shu'ub and mallahu bihi alim. The Shaykh Nahi gave us the evidences from the kitab. Now he's going to give us the evidence from the sunnah. Wa amma dalalatu sunnah. As for the evidences from the sunnah, ala hadha al-asl al-azimi, based on this great fundamental point, which is to unite upon the haq and to differ, the prohibition of it. The sunnah has also clarified it. Faqad qala Rasulullah, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, al-muslimu akhul muslim, the believer is the brother of another believer. La yadhlimuhu wa la yakhdhulhu wa la yahqirhu, he does not oppress him. Wa la yakhdhulhu, he does not khidlan is when you hayafadda, look for the word khidlan, I don't remember the English word for it. He does not deceive him. Khidlan is to deceive. La yadhlimu, does not oppress him. Wala yakhdhulhu, and he does not deceive him. Wala yahqirhu, and he does not belittle him. At-taqwa hahuna, the taqwa is here. At-taqwa hahuna, the taqwa is here. وَيَشِيرُ إِلَىٰ صَدْرِهِ, and the Prophet pointed towards his chest. بِحَسْبِ مْرِئٍ مِّنَ الشَّرِّ, sufficient for a person, evil is, أَن يَحْقِرَ أَخَاهُ الْمُسْلِمَ, for him to belittle his Muslim brother, that is sufficient for him, sin. كُلُّ الْمُسْلِمِ عَلَى الْمُسْلِمِ حَرَامٍ, every Muslim to another Muslim is prohibited. دَمُهُ, his blood. وَعِرْضُهُ, his honor. وَمَالُهُ, his wealth. وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ, in another wording, لَا تَحَاسَدُوا, don't hate one another. وَلَا تَبَاغَضُوا, don't show each other enmity. وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا, وَلَا تَحَسَّسُوا, and don't spy on one another. وَلَا تَنَاجَشُوا, تَنَاجُش is when a person comes to the market and you don't want to buy this product, but you just make the price go up. In auctions, a person will just come in, he's selling something, another person will come and he will just put the price up. So it goes, becomes expensive, he doesn't want to buy it. وَلَا تَنَاجَشُوا, don't do tanajus on one another. He's not intended to buy the product. So for example, you Sa'ad want to buy a product from our brother Zayd, for example. So Zayd is selling the product. I don't want to buy the product. I have no intention of buying the product. So what do? I come and I see the price is £5. I'm going to make it reach £50 by competing with you because I know you want it so much. And then when it reaches £50 and you're not stopping, I just stop and I leave there. And I never had the intention to buy it, but the price is 50 at you and you have to buy it at price 50 because you agreed to 50. وَلَا تَنَاجَشُوا, don't do tanajus on one another. وَكُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانًا, and be the slaves of Allah who are brothers. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said, وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ, in another wording, لَا تَقَاطَعُوا, don't boycott one another. وَلَا تَدَابَرُوا, don't turn your backs on one another. وَلَا تَبَاغَضُوا, don't hate one another. وَلَا تَحَاسَدُوا, don't show enmity to one another and jealousy. وَكُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانًا, and be brothers who are the slaves of Allah. وَيَقُولُ عَلَيْهِ صَلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ, and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الْمُؤْمِنُ لِلْمُؤْمِنِ كَالْبُنْيَانِ, a believer to another believer is like a construction. يَشُدُّ بَعْضُهُ بَعْضًا, they strengthen one another. وَقَالَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, لِأَبِي أَيُّوبَ رضي الله تعالى عنه, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to لِأَبِي أَيُّوبَ الْأَنصَارِ, he said to him, أَلَا أَدُلُّكَ عَلَى تِجَارَةٍ, shall I show you a trading? Shall I indicate and show you a trading? قَالَ بَلَى, he said, of course, O Messenger of Allah. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, تَسْعَى فِي الْإِصْلَاحِ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ, you strive to bring in good between the Muslims. إِذَا تَفَاسَدُوا, when their corruption occurs between them. وَتُقَارِبْ بَيْنَهُمْ إِذَا تَبَاعَدُوا, and you bring them close to one another when they are far from one another. The hadith Imam al-Bayhaqi narrated in his Shu'ab, Haythami narrated in his Mujma' al-Zawaid wa Manba' al-Fawaid, and al-Haythami, he said, Rawahu al-Bazzar, but in the chain of narration is Abdul Rahman ibn Abdullah al-Umariyu, and he is a person whose narration is left. وفي مقابلة وفي مقابلة أمر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المؤمنين بالتحاب والتآلف تآلفي. Also on the contrary is what the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم ordering the believers to love one another. بالتحاب to come with محبة love for one another. والتآلف and to bring their hearts to one to one another. ومحبة الخير and loving good, والتعاون على البر والتقوى, and supporting and aiding one another upon the good and piety, وفعل الأسباب, and coming with the means, التي تقوي ذلك, that strengthens this, وتنميه, and that nurtures it, في مقابلة ذلك, and in the contrary, the opposite, نهى النبي, the Prophet prohibited, عن كل ما يوجب, he prohibited anything that will necessitate تفرق the differing and the disunity of the Muslims وتباعدهم and them distancing from one another وذلك لما في التفرق والبغضاء من المفاسد العظيمة and the reason why he did that the messenger is because of the great harm that is in disunity and the enmity and hate فالتفرق disunity هو قرة عين الشياطين. It is the warmth and the joy of the eyes. It brings warmth and joy to the eyes of shaitan. The shaitan which are al-jinni, the shayateen of the jinn. And the shayateen of the ins. It brings warmth to their eyes. لأن الشياطين الإنسي. Because the shayateen of the humans, والجنني, لا يودون, they don't want, من أهل الإسلام, they don't want, they don't wish and hope for, من أهل الإسلام, from the people of Islam, أن يجتمعوا على شيء, for them to unite upon a matter, they don't want that. فهم يريدون, what they want is, أن يتفرقوا, for them to become to have disunity with them. That's what they want. لأنهم, because, يعلمون, they know, أن التفرق, disunity, is what? تفتت للقوة, it disperses the ability and the strength, التي تحت, التي, the one, تحصل بالالتزام والاتجاه إلى الله عز وجل. The strength that occurs when the people stick to facing Allah تبارك وتعالى. فالنبي, the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, حث, he urged us, على التآلف والتحاب, for us to love one another. بقوله وفعله, he told us this by his speech and his actions. ونهى, and he prohibited, عن التفرق والاختلاف, and he also prohibited from us to disunity and differing that which will lead to إلى تفريق الكلمة, that our words will be not unified, وذهاب الريح, and that our strength will go. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he prohibited that from us صلى الله عليه وسلم. And this, the ulama know it as this type of prohibition, which the Prophet prohibits something that may lead to, because the Sheikh said, الَّذِي يُؤَدِّي, that may lead to the Muslims' words not becoming together or their strength going, it is known as سد الذرائع. It's a qa'ida which is سد الذرائع. The Prophet closed off every means that may lead to the Muslim to lose the unity. The Muslims to lose the unity. And also their strength and their ability to go. And from those things that are prohibited, which is what? Debating. That is not done upon the haqq. The debating that is not done upon the haqq, that is one of the things that are prohibited because it breaks the unity. Al-mujadalati, the debates and the arguments that are not based upon the haqq. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he prohibited that because it's from those things that lead to harmful matters. Also, he prohibited sallallahu alaihi wasallam the breaking of promises. If a person promises a person something, the promises are one of those things that lead to what? The Muslims not uniting. And it also leads to the weakness of the Muslims. The Sheikh now, he mentions the Kitab and he mentioned the Sunnah, and now he's going to mention the Sahabas. وَأَمَّا عَمَلُ الصَّحَابَةِ. As for the actions of the Sahabas that indicate the unity and the prohibition of disunity. فَقَدْ وَقَعَ بَيْنَهُمُ الْإِخْتِلَافُ. The Sahabas, they differed. Oh yes, they did. فَقَدْ وَقَعَ. It occurred. بَيْنَهُم. Between themselves. رَضْوَانُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. May Allah be pleased with all of them. Differing. اختلاف, differing, occurred between the Sahabas. لكن, but, لم يحصل به التفرق ولا العداوة ولا البغضاء. But, the differing did not lead to, or it did not bring disunity, enmity and hate. It didn't bring it. فقد حصل الخلاف. The differing came, they differed on matters, بينهم, between themselves. في عهد رسول الله, at the time of the messenger, they differed in between themselves whilst the messenger was amongst them. ورسول الله بين أظهرهم, and the prophet was amongst them. They differed. نعم. فمن ذلك, from them is أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now there's one example now. For example of that is أن النبي, the messenger, لما فرغ من غزوة الأحزاب. When the messenger, he finished the battle of Ahzab. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the battle of Ahzab, when he finished it. وجاءه جبريل, and Jibril came to him. يأمره, ordering the Prophet. أن يخرج إلى بني قريظة لنقضهم العهد. To go to the tribe بنو قريظة. And they are one of the three tribes of the Jews that lived in Medina. Go to them, because they broke the promise. Whilst you guys were fighting with the people of Ghazwat al-Ahzab, they broke the promise. So the messenger was ordered by Jibril that he has to go and fight with the people of Banu Qurayza, because they broke لِنَقْضِهِمْ. Naqd is breaking. Al-Ahda, they broke the contract and the treaty. They broke that contract. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأصحابه, the Prophet said to his companions, لا يصلين أحد منكم العصر إلا في بني قريظة. None of you prays Asr except in بني قريظة. Meaning don't pray Salatul Asr except in بني قريظة. فخرجوا من المدينة. The Sahabas, they left Medina. Where did they go to? إلى بني قريظة. They went to بني قريظة. وحان وقت صلاة العصر. The time of صلاة العصر entered. فقال بعضهم, some of them said, لا نصلي, we're not going to pray, إلا في بني قريظة, we're not going to pray except in بني قريظة. ولو غابت الشمس, even if the sun sets, we're not going to pray except when we go to بني قريظة. Why? لِأَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صلى الله عليه وسلم, because the Prophet said to us, لَا يُصَلِّيَنَّ أَحَدٌ مِّنْكُمُ الْعَصْرَ إِلَّا فِي بَنُو قُرَيْضَةِ. Because the Prophet said to us, لَا يُصَلِّيَنَّ, none of you should pray الْعَصْرَ, no one of you should pray عَصْر إِلَّا فِي بَنِو قُرَيْضَةِ except in the tribe of بَنُو قُرَيْضَةِ. فَنَقُولُ, we will say, سَمِعْنَا, we heard that which you said, O Messenger of Allah, وَأَطَعْنَا. So this group, they said, whatever the Prophet said to us, we hear it and we obey it. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَالَ, from them were those who said, نُصَلِّي فِي الْوَقْتِ, we're going to pray Asr at its time. Why? Are they opposing the Prophet's statement? No. لِأَنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, because the Messenger, أَرَادَ بِذَلِكَ الْمُبَادَرَةَ وَالْإِسْرَاعَ إِلَى الْخُرُوجِ. Because the Messenger, أَرَادَ, he wanted, بِذَلِكَ, with this command, الْمُبَادَرَة, for us to hasten, وَالْإِسْرَاعَ, to hasten, they both mean hasting. Mubadara is to run and do quickly. Isra' is sur'ah, it means to do something fast. But hasten and to do what fast?